Y'all, this is, all right, recap. Hopefully the internet keeps up. Let me exit off some of these things here. Exit off of here. Let me exit off Facebook again. Bruh, bruh, yeah. What's up? Click, click. All right, y'all. So we're talking about Eat the Wars Live. Who are the and? I've covered this video before, but now we got some new people. So I'm going to cover some of my work, but a little bit more in depth in this cycle. All right. So Eat the Wars. Who are the and? You guys might notice at the end of most constellations, you have an and, a on, a us, okay, or a day. All right. Or a pi. All right, the PIs and other stuff come later, but usually you have the utterance is of dragons. Why do we have the utterance of the dragons? Because before everything was created, it was contained within called Tiamat, chaos. So we're going to talk a little bit about Tiamat and chaos and the ands and the ohms. So the utterance of the dragon is on, om, ah, hu, he, ra. Okay, so when these dragons will utter these different sounds and tones, they literally would rip portals into realities and fucking things will be created. So this is how you get hu, which is color, all right? Or hu, which is feline also. Hu man, feline man. So that would be those. Or hu, which is also associated with the dragon, Allah hu. Okay, which is all the Islamic culture and stuff like that is all based around the dragon, where they're talking their Arabic language that is serpent dragonoid language. That's because that cube is a container for some of the essences and things that belong to Allah. I can't go too much into that, but that's what we're talking about. So we're going to talk about the ants. All right, so a lot of times y'all see ancient Sumerian, y'all see these tall white beings or what look like white beings with beards and stuff. Those are not the real Anunnaki. They're part of the Anunnaki. The Anunnaki are not just one particular species. It's like 27 different species. In the higher class, it's like 12 of them, and then there's 24 other classes that break off in multiple dimensions and stuff. And you have subspecies. So the particular ones are breaking down into councils and families. So you have groups of ants, groups of ohms, and so on and so forth. The own is usually was the precursor to a lot of these things as well as the ant. But during the time frames, you would notice that Orion, right? Orion, Orion, all right? Orion, and all the Baron, the bull, are locked into the eternal war. And this is the war of the ethers. This is depicted in the show Thor Ragnarok. Thor Ragnarok was actually about the All the Baron's son, right? And this is what a lot of the Akkadian, see, the Akkadian, those are all the Baron people. So this is why you have all these depictions of all the Barons and these tall beings or whatever like that, that were Nordic looking beings. In actuality, they were never able to actually depict the Anunnaki because they were reptilian, and you're not supposed to, in their culture, in reptilian culture, you can't depict them as anything. They shapeshift. So you don't see them that way because it's fucking horrible. Have a heart attack, your chest would explode if you saw one of these things, if you saw what we truly look like. So we're going to talk about the origins of these things, and then I'm going to go into DNA, and then I'm going to talk about breaking down their culture. A lot of their culture is European, the Viking culture. This is where you see the dudes with the big old horns and their replication, because that is their ancestor, which is the bull man, which was one of the monsters and creatures of Tiamat, which we used to create this particular species. All right, that and a hairy or a shaggy. All right, so shout out to those who are watching. I know this is a lot of information, but this is why I don't do this very often, because it is a lot. All right, y'all. So we're gonna go into Tiamat. All right, remember in the last video, I told you guys it was Tiamat Re'ol. Is all right, but notice most of all this stuff, you're gonna notice a pattern of what Akkadian, Akkadian. All right. The DN should tell you all where it is, Aldebaran. Okay, so in the religion of ancient Babylon, Tiamat, okay, Tiamat or Tiatun, see? So as you get the younger generations, they started changing it. You have the sound of creation, Tiamat Tum, all right, is a primordial goddess of the Salton Sea, which is the celestial Salton Sea, mating with Abzu, the god of fresh water, to produce younger gods. So she is the symbol of chaos to primordial creation. She is referred to as a woman or a feminine aspect, described as a glistening one. Okay, it is suggested that there are two parts of Tiamat's myth. The first one is Tiamat is the creator goddess, and through a sacred marriage, right, between salt water and fresh water, peacefully created the cosmos through the successive generations. All right, and the second, which is the chaos of or whatever, Tiamat is considered the monstrous embodiment of primordial chaos. Why was she the monstrous primordial of chaos? This is because this is from the Aldebaran side. The Aldebarans were dragon killers, dragon hunters. You always see them depicted with their tridents or whatever, trying to kill the black dragon. Okay? So this has nothing to do with race. This has all to do with extraterrestrial DNA. So if anybody's uncomfortable by this, I'm sorry, but this is the truth. Okay? So from their perspective, what is it? Attack the beautiful dragon of the universe and kill it. So some of the sources identify with her with the images of the sea serpent or dragon. In the Enuma Elish, the Babylonian epic of creation, she gives birth to the first creation of deities, her husband Abzu, correctly assuming they are planning to kill him, usurps the throne, later makes war upon them and is killed and enraged. She too wars upon her husband's murderers, taking on the form of a massive sea dragon. Notice she shapeshifted, changed into a massive what? Sea dragon. All right. She is then slain by, allegedly, they say, my son Marduk, or Enki's son Marduk, but that is not true because Marduk is not a person. Here's where it gets tricky, guys. Marduk is not a person. Marduk is a group of people. These are the Dukes of Mars. All right, because what? Marduk had it. Mars was a way station. All right. There's still a base on Mars, and it is still a way station for who? Alalu. But that's a later story. That goes into the a dragon under the Vatican type shit. All right. So they say Marduk. That's not true. Okay. The true actual story before they altered it is it was created naturally through sacred marriage before these motherfuckers came and fucked it up. All right. So let's see. They're within the star realm. They're what we call trophy hunters. Like they just ride around and just kill shit and collect shit. Like it's really bad. That's what they do nowadays. Okay. So, but not before she had brought forth the monsters of the Mesopotamian pantheon, including first what? The first dragons whose bodies were filled with poison instead of blood. And then Marduk then forms the heavens and the earths and divide her body, which is not true. Okay. The truth is, all right, that Tiamat actually sacrificed herself, and thus she was consumed, and that's how she was created by the into the cosmos. Okay, because the proper way is story is that Abzu died because what? He was killed by Enki. Abzu was killed by Enki because Abzu was crazy and Abzu liked to eat his own grandchildren. That's another story that's personal. So he wanted to eat his own grandchildren, which was a sacred ritual that when they ate the children, they were realms. So they were actually bringing them forth into existence by eating them. By making the mistake of killing him, it kind of cut off half of the universe, which usurped the balance. And thus, primordial chaos happened, and she had to sacrifice herself. This is what happens when it's called flesh eat of my flesh, blood of my blood, bone of my bone. All right? Now, that is called the sacred death. All right? The Nomos and the Dagons talk about the sacred death, as well as some Mayan cultures where they would ritualistic suicide. All right? By what? Getting eaten by the dragon or getting eaten by the serpent. Okay? That's sacred shit, and I just told y'all that, so I'm just going to let y'all know that. So it was sacred death. The Nomos and the Dagons talk about when The Nomos landed here. Hopefully you guys can see me, right? When the Nomos landed here, the king of the Nomos, right? When he landed, he talked to the tribe leader or whatever when he came down to the people. And what did he do? He killed himself and allowed the rest of them to eat him. And the one who would assume king ate him first. And this is the origin of breaking bread, flesh, you know, whole Jesus Christ thing. It comes from dragons. Okay? So that's the flesh, either my flesh, blood, or my bone. A lot of the shit is, yeah, a lot of the shit that they don't know. So when I say this shit, I'm telling y'all from firsthand experience, and I'm glad only three people are watching by the power of 3x3. All right? There was actually 3 sons at the time. All right? So once I was consumed by this giant dragon, I had to get out of there, and that's how I became Ea. All right? So I was eaten by Abzu, and I had to kill him to get out. So I had to kill my own grandfather in that lifetime to get out. And thus, here I am. All right. So we're going to get into a little bit more deeper into this shit. All right. A lot of people are going to watch this later. I was going to do a live reading, but there's not a lot of people watching. So let's just end it off like this. But we got some more deeper shit to get into. So hang on to your seats. Let Grandpa Inky teach you a story. All right. So, notice this shit, Thor Kid Jacobson. All right, that whole history of Thor and them and shit, that comes from all the Aldebarans, all right? That's real technology, that's the Hadron Colliders, and we're going to get to Hadron Colliders. That's a whole one in itself, because that's talking about ripping ripples of time and shit like that. That's how Mars got exploded, fucking Hadron Colliders and hydrogen, what is it? Hydroatomic bombs, because we use water for everything. Both argue connection with the Akkadian word for sea is Tamatu, following the earlier form of Tayataum, Atum. Y'all hear that? That's the Kemetic in it, because y'all have to understand it was the 12 tribes of Earth, right? And Nubia and all that stuff was the home of An and Atum. And so here you have it. The early form is T. Amatatum. I'm trying to pronounce it right. Tia Amtum or Atum. Continues by a linguistic connection to the Typhes. All right. Now, when you get to Typhes, then you get into what? Typhon. All right. That's the dragon serpent thingy with the head. That's a whole nother subject, too. All right. Because we're talking about the creatures of which these modern L beings came from before they became Nordic beings. They were grafted from bull men, all right? And this is the origin of your Satan, because they were the guardians of Saturn, the cube, the sacred cube, all right? So I can't see our comments either, so. The latter form is Thalate, which appears in the Hellenistic Babylon writer Broius' first volume of Universal History, is clearly related to the Greek Thalata. I'm not too fan of Thalissa, Thessalonius. Check it, all right? C, it is that the proper name is Tiamat, which is constructed a vocational form and dropped into the secondary translations of the original text, become some Akkadian copywriters of the numeralist substituted the word Tiamatu with C. See, you hear them substituting shit, making up shit, that's because all the half of the shit is fragmented. So they putting shit in here, just to let y'all know. So this is why we have to come and incarnate in this lifetime to give y'all accurate information to tell our story. Whether you believe it or not, hey, that's on you. Do you believe or do you know? Okay, I know. I was there. I have 100% memory of this. And this is why I share this with you. So you can know yourself too. All right. So it says, when above the heavens did not exist, nor did the earth below. Abzu, the freshwater ocean, was there. The first, the begotter. Tiamat, the saltwater sea. She who bore them all. They were mixing their waters. They were mating. All right? This is the higher and lower, high, high, high. So this is like, I'm not going to tell you what dimension, but I've been there.
So it's thought that the female's deities are other than males in Mesopotamia.
Yes, that's because the Sakigamis were what? They were African and Kemetic in origin, and from those origins they had reptilians, which is matriarchal. All
right. Because they don't tell you the whole reptilian part of this. They only tell you a little bit. All right, so she bore them all, mixing their waters. Tiamat has been begotten a part of a cult life as Namu, because Namu was the incarnation. Each incarnation cycle, you have the ultimate two pairs who represents Abzu and Tiamat, and they have to come together in a sacred union, and that is the prophecy to be fulfilled every time the incarnation cycle happens. Okay. So a female principle of the watery creative force, right? The womb, the darkness. Tiamat was the triple darkness, all right? The carbon body. They would call her in the material world a Sayakar, which is a big-ass black dragon. Look it up. With equally strong connections to the underworld, which predates the appearance of Ea, Enki, which is true.
Because at that time, it wouldn't be no Eans. E-N is associated with lordship. All right? Up there, you would have Anship. Okay? Because the An represents the sky being in the higher realm. The An, the great mountains. All right?
Which is inside the realm. You feel me? So, Harriet Crawford finds the mixing of the waters to the natural feature of the Persian Gulf, which is fresh waters, the Arabic aquifer mix and mingle with the salt waters of the sea. The characteristics especially true of the religion of Bahran,
Aldebaran,
right? Whose name in Arabic is Two Seas, which is thought to be the site of Mun, the original site of the Sumerian creation beliefs, right? The difference is the density of the salt and fresh water principle separation, all right? What's up,
y'all? I'm about to take a seat real quick. And keep giving it to y'all. So we're trying to break a lot of this shit down for y'all as much as I can. And we're only like 22 minutes in. So, like I said, it takes a lot to break a lot of this shit down. And we haven't even gotten to the DNA part or me breaking down the sequences of DNA and stuff like that yet. So hang on. All right. All right. So in the Enuma Elish, her physical description, right? Remember this, guys, a tail, a thigh, the lower part, which shake together, a belly, a udder, ribs, a neck, a head, skull, eyes, nostrils, mouth, lips, and horns, entrails and hearts and arteries and blood. Okay. Tiamat is described as a sea serpent dragon, although Assyrians, we'll get into that at another time, disagreed with the identification, argued that the dragon form cannot be imputed to Tiamat with certainty. See, they're disputing amongst themselves and shit. It's not convincing, blah, 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 bullshit. Reason to believe Tiamat was sometimes not necessarily always conceived as a dragoness. The Enuma Elish states that she gave birth to dragons and serpents. See, these are the primordial ones. All right. So when people be like, what's up, Titan? What's up, Titan? What's up, Titan? Y'all talking about y'all opposition. Y'all not talking about who you are, because look at it. Tight tit. All right. And if you look at the depiction of the Ands or the Barons, they're all freaking Titans. They're all half metal, half human. They're transhuman. All right. Titans represent what? The tit. All right. Which is the otter. Okay. Which represents what? The bull. Okay. Or the cow or the buck. Okay. So, what else are we talking about? Dragons and serpents. A general list of monsters includes scorpion men and mer people. Okay. And mer people. Those are called the Onesses and different stuff like that.
but do not identify her form as a dragon, however sources, blah, blah, blah. Tiamat is a multi-headed dragon, and they popularize her in Dungeons and Dragons, okay? So here's the mythology. This is going to break where we get broken down into some stuff. Abzu, or Abzu, all right? Fathered upon Tiamat, the elder gods, Lamu and Lahamu, all right? The hairy, okay? These are your Shaggies. These are your Orion Shetties, which a particular strain of them were created from as well, okay? So a title given to the gatekeepers of Inki's Abzu, Inkura Temple, and Eridu. So this is what you see when you see the bull, the, not the bull, the shaggy people or whatever. Those are the Bigfoots, and they usually used to guard the Temple of Eridu. Then a lot of their spirits still are around me till this day. I love those guys. So they're dope. They'll teach you some shit, some magic shit. Lahamu and Lahamu, in turn, were the parents of the ends of the heavens, which is Anshar. Anshar is what? Anshar is Saturn, at least in this particular lifetime. It's Saturn, okay? Ansar, okay? Ansar. And then you have, and what else do you get? You get Ansar Allah. You get all these different kind of words from here. Ansar. Heaven, total end. In the earth, Kishar, right? Well, you can arrange this when it's dealing with just the earthly. Anshar and Kishar is talking about Anshar being the heavens and Ki being the earth, or Kishar. All right, Anshar and Kishar were considered to meet at what? The horizon. Okay, and I'm not going to go into that particular realm. Becoming thereby the parents of Anu. Okay, there is no Anu. Anu is Uranus. All right, your Anu is the UN. Okay, because if you type in UN, it's the same thing. So Anu is the UN, and later became a people. It's not a the most supreme god. That's On. All right, that's the god of the multiverse. Heaven and Earth. Tiamat was shining personification of salt water, who roared and smote chaos of the original creation. She and Abzu filled the cosmic abyss with the primeval waters. She is Umuhuber. See? Who? Umuhuber. See? And you can tell this relates a lot closer to African language and dialect. Umuhuber. All right? So who formed all things? Matter. In their recorded cuneiform tablets, the deity Inki, or Ea, believed correctly that Abzu was planning to murder the younger deities, upset with the noisy Talmud they created, so captured him and held him prisoner in his temple in Ea Abzu. Then angered Kingu, their son, who reported the event to Tia, whereas she fashioned 11, right? Now, boom, 11. Elven, all right, 11 dimensions, all right, monsters to battle the deities in order to avenge Abzu's death. They were her own offspring, Bashamu, the venomous snake, Ushimgalu. Okay, Ushimgalu. I had one of them. Hold on, nigga, who was that moment? Ushimgalu. Y'all will notice that the Galu, the Lu, all right, is also close to Hu, okay, which is also dragon. This is where you get Elu and Lil. Enlil is also known as what? The red and black dragon, all right? Also holding the lion that's representative of the constellations, all right? These were all constellations at this time before they got embodied. Musuhahu, the exalted serpent, right? Look at all serpents, dragons, and shit. Okay? Mushu Sasu. Mushu Su.
Okay, there's the Shu and from Comedics. The Furious Snake, Lahamu, the Hairy One, Ugalu, the Big Weather Beast. Okay, then where you get the Gal later on, this is where you get Angel. So you have An and a Gal, okay, and a Galu, all right, and this is where you get Angal, all right, the formation of angels, those who bend the angles and light rays, all right. So the Big Weather Beast, which is a bird, all right, Iridimu, the Mad Lion, okay, so the Mad Lion. All right, so you see you have Elu or Enlil holding what? Iridumu, which is the Mad Lion. All right, then you have Garita Bulu, which is Scorpion Man. And this is where they seen they depicted the Scorpion King. All right, so Umu Dabarotu is the Violent Storms. Okay, this is where you get your storm gods and you get the Umites. All right, this is all primordial. Then you get Kalulu. All right, Kalulu. This is where they get the Cthulhu. Cthulhu is not a person, it is a bunch of beings. All right, they're called the Fishman, also known as the Onis. And then you get Kusariku, which is Bullman, which is the Baron. All right, I wish I had pictures for this, but I'm gonna make a better one, that even better with, you know, all the stuff. That's Bullman. Okay, y'all? So Tiamat possessed the tablets of destinies. In a primordial battle, she gave them to Kingu. Okay? The deity she had chosen as her lover and the leader of her host, who was also one of her children, but everyone was her children. The deities gathered in terror, but Anu, or Yuan, replaced later the first by Enlil in the late version, blah blah blah, tablets of death, Marnie, blah blah blah. So they always switch them up each time a new god takes a position in the celestial hierarchies. All right, so whoever is holding the cup at the time first extracted a promise that he would be reverted as the king of the gods, overcame her, armed with the arrows of the winds and nets and a club and invincible spear. In an invisible spear, and the Lord stood upon Tiamat's hind parts. And notice that in the Bible, they say, in the Lord, they're talking about different beings. These are the elves, the lords, you know what I'm saying? Lord gods, those who are of the lower realms in their lordship. All right. And with the merciless club, he smashed her skull. He cut through the channels of her blood, and he made the north wind bear it away in the secret places. All right, slicing Tiamat in half, he made from her ribs the vault of heaven and earth. All right, the true story is that Kingu actually just killed her and stole the shit and caused a whole upheaval and manipulated everything. And this is why Kingu, in some stories, was killed to create mankind, which Kingu is a white dragon, the moon. All right, and he was used to create mankind, another form of reptilian or their particular creation stories, because there's several different types of species on this earth before everything got intermingled. Her weeping eyes became the source of the Tigris and Euphrates rivers. Her tail became the Milky Way. And with the approval of the elder deities, he took from Kingu the Tablet of the Destinies and installed himself as the head of the pantheon. Kingu was captured and later slain. His red blood mixed with the red clay of the earth will make the body of what? Humankind. All right, kind of like humans, created to act as a servant of the younger Igigi deities. Okay, these were servants of the younger Igigi. The Igigi, right, are the lizards. Okay, these are your lower reptilian lizards, and they're albino, and these are your world leaders today. All right, and who's under their rule? Now you know. And they take their orders from way up top by the ants. Any questions, anybody? Let's see. Because I know I'm going on for a while.
reading y'all comments. Okay, perfect, y'all. So just reading y'all comments, try to get some in here. Like I said, if more people come, I might do a free reading session. So with the approval of the elder guys, blah, blah, blah. Let's see. And that's pretty much what I have to show y'all for that one. All right. So that's just covering what the fragments that you guys have in this reality. All right. That's just piecing together the overall what people think story. Okay. So in European culture, you guys have the Greeks. Okay, which are the other younger versions of these guys. And they talk about what? The Titans being chained down into Tartarus. Where's Tartarus? It's Aldebaran. It's in the Eye of the Bull. All right. Don't ask me what book. Don't ask me what book. This is a secret book about. I'm sharing with y'all today. Okay. All right, y'all, let's see. Aldebaran, Alpha Aldebaran, okay? Epilepsion, you see? The and on, and then what? Alcleon, all right? Alcleon, y'all he see the and on within their entire little constellation thingy, all right? Then you have the Pleiadians, boom. So now you know the Pleiadians, which are the Nordics. All the Nordics come from here, all right? And guess what? They're all fighting y'all melanated asses who are non-Nordic. They're always fighting what? And this is not to make, this is just ether wars, the war of the ethers, okay? What they're talking about in Thor is the nine realms. Check it. Okay, when they talking about Ragnarok, they talking about that solar plexus inside of you, and when it ignites, you can blow up their sun. You know what I'm saying? Like you're going to go big into Hallel. That's what they showed in Thor Ragnarok. That fire being, that's another version of Enlil. That was Hallel, and they showed him, and he had with the flaming sword and everything, because it was his prophecy, it was his destiny to destroy them for destroying the primordials. And they had to flee from Auriga, right? Which is that golden city that y'all see, which they call Asgard. Asgard is Auriga. See? So let's see, who is this? This, okay, they got a kind of feminine right here version. But boom, you have, don't ask me what book. All right. Remember, I was telling y'all about the fourth dimension Beltegeese. Y'all have gray aliens in this star system. Y'all have some of the lion people of Regal. This is where the elves come from, the other lion people. They come from the foot, okay? They've got this wrong because they got, this is a, wait, nope. I was going to say, they got this wrong because that's supposed to be Ilanak and Iliun and the other ones. But like I said, these people only been on the earth about 4,000 years, so they, of course, they don't know what they're talking about. So, yeah, hell no, ain't no Zeta in fucking Orion. The hell? All right, so don't mind the inaccuracy of this. All right, so boom, they're fighting Orion. The bull and Orion have been locked in eternal ether war for eternity, because it's eternal. Okay, flesh eat of my flesh, bone my bone, sacred death. All right, ritualistic suicide, fighting that. And this is why they show the Matator and the bull and the whole red cloth thingy and shit like that, because that's been going, it's a bull race, you know what I'm saying? So
I'll go in a little bit deeper for y'all right now, right? And then we're going to go into that a little bit more, if y'all can hang in there, because I got some more right here, fresh off that I was writing. So that's why I said, y'all be asking me to teach. I got to teach. Like, it goes on. Like, this is not just kindergarten. No, you have to learn the stars. Can you learn the constellations and their movements? Okay? That's in the Bible, Job. All right. So, all right. So Orion, the famous red star, is second brightest, is Orion, located in the Hunter's right shoulder. His Beltagese is one of the largest stars in astronomers. The name Beltagese is a result of the translation of Arabic into medieval Latin. As mentioned in chapter one, astronomy saw the constellation as a female figure they called Aljaza. Often referred to as the central one, okay? This is where one of the great central suns are. The Arabic name for Beltagese is Yad Ad Yauza, all right? The hand of Yauza. In medieval times, this is translated into Latin because bad Al-Gauza, meaning the armpit of Al-Yauza or some shit like that. During the resistance, bad Al-Gauza eventually became Beltagese. Is equally aligned with Mars and Mercury, but this is modern times. This ain't at that time. So this is what they associated with in Nordic philosophy. They always associate him with Odin. I mean, we know who Odin is. Odin is also An, all the Baron. I mean, not An, it's An and Anu. Or whatever. So the bull, let's talk a little bit about this. All right. So the constellation is Latin for the bull, Taurus. All right. The bordering constellation are, as they show you in the movie, Thor Ragnarok, or what is it? When they was going up to the ethers and shit like that, fighting over the ethers. They show you the whole nother species as they're there with the big horns and stuff, and they're fighting the dark elves. The dark elves are little time looper thingies and shit that can control the ethers and stuff like that. That's real. They've taken all this shit and from all these ancient epic stories where they talk about heroes, right? Heroes of old, men of renown. These are turned into your comics now, okay? So they also show beings that had other type horns. Watch the movie, y'all. Y'all notice that they did have different types of horn. That is Aries. Okay. You have Auriga, which is Asgard. Asgard is based off of Auriga constellation in that realm. You have Cetus, which I talk about is in Black Panther. That's Bas or Basset. That's Cetus. All right. And then you got Eridanus. Okay, where the Anus come from, Eridanu, see, all right, and those are over the planetary lords, all right, which is your lord Ans or lord gods, those who are in the position to hand over or take care of celestial bodies, such as planets and stuff. So when you become a lord An, you become or a Anu. That means that you're initiated to become a head or over celestial bodies and shit like that. Everybody get it? All right. So, Auriga, Cetus, Eridani, Gemini, Orion, and Perseus, okay? In Pleiades, you have Apollyon, Astrophemi, Taiga, Selonian, Electra, Myapa, and Merope. Okay? Let's see. Okay, the name is Latin for it says let's see, the three star brightest stars are Orion belt toward the northwest to Aldebaran. The brightest star in Taurus, the bull's horns are formed by a V shape. All right, now this is the V shape. When you see people doing like this shit, yeah, that's they shit. That's vril society. They using vril energy. Because remember, it talked about a thunder being, too, a storm thunder being. They killed that thing because they're trophy hunters. It was a dude that used to come on my lives
And I used to say, "Hey, what's up, Aldebaran?" That was him because he was weird a little bit, and I had to block him. But they're collectors, and they're just fucking hunters of the galaxy, and it's fucked up because they just go hunt rare shit, nagas and shit, and they have, and like you could tell like one of them because they always have a long beard, which is kind of red or whitish or whatever, and they have a bunch of just junk and shit in their house, hella spiritual shit that you don't need. Like, dude had like fucking, his whole house was just a collector shit. And you could tell that that's what they do in the Astral Realm. They go and hunt and kill shit and take over information and just fucking pirates pretty much. Just like they showed him in Thor. Okay. So, it is Latin for the bull. Also noted to carry the entry for the Pleiades. It was derived as Atutra. Okay, Atura. Aturaya. All right. Atua, Aturaya. The stars of Aether. Okay. Or Hathor, which symbolizes the Aether. But the Hathor is what? The lioness, which has to do with regal. Okay. Which is all in what? Orion. Okay, now y'all seeing the flow of the star nations, all right? So it says during the last Bronze Age, when it was marked the sun's location during the spring equinox, depictions of Taurus and Pleiades have been found in the Lacoste Grotto in France and date back to approximately 15,000 BC. In Mesopotamia, this constellation was known as the Bull of Light. It was equated to what? The god Marduk. All right, so now y'all get it that it was these motherfuckers fucking it up all the time. There was never a Marduk. It was only an Amarotu. And Amarotu was the sun. All right, and they show the sun in there. These beings were the Dukes of Mars that were pretty much the ones that raided and warred on Mars and shit like that. The nine realms, the last nine planets after Nibiru had fucking went rogue and shit and all types of shit, and the realm started collapsing and we only had nine dimensions left, which would be the nine dimensions would be the nine cubes which all the planets are contained in. There were nine of them, and then you got, you know, a lot of information, guys. I know. So the Pleiades bull was prominent animal in cults of Babylon and Persia. Both Taurus and the Pleiades have been known through many indigenous cultures referred to as the bull in the seven sisters. All right. So I talk about that in the Bible too. But I won't get too much into that because we're already at 40 minutes and I still got to go in on the shit just straight off of what I was writing. So the Taurus is associated with what? Zeus. All right. Zeus is associated with what? Jupiter, the frost giants, right? The snow shetty. All right. I'm just throwing out these different species so y'all can grasp it because I'm going to show you how these things intertangle. Oh, I wasn't supposed to show y'all my book, but whatever. I'll show you how these things intertangle. but let's see. Zeus, which is a Jupiter. So that brings me to the other part. The second half that y'all were seeing from Thor Ragnarok was actually Jupiter ascending. Okay, Jupiter ascending was talking about the different species and the draconians and stuff, and you can see that the golden lady, which she was melanated, she was so melanated to the point she was gold. She was the slave, and all the golden people were slaves. While Jupiter was ascending, Zeus, right? Europa, where they get Europe. Okay. So for all my people talking about white people don't come from this constellation, we come from stars. No, everybody comes from stars. Everybody. I mean, not everybody comes from that. It's a star seed. Everybody has latent DNA that is left yet to be unlocked. That is 97% unused, which means that it's extraterrestrial. It's foreign to the human body. Or your human body is foreign to it. Who knows? So the Phoenicians, which later another transmutation of these things, the Phoenicians, when they had the red hair, the princess Europa. All right. When she climbed onto his back, he abducted her, carried her to Crete. All right. They eventually had three sons. See? One of whom became King Minos of Crete. Minos commissioned the first place of Kenos, which annually seven maidens in youth were sacrificed to a Minotaur, bull man. All right. Now, y'all seen me post the thing about American Horror Story Coven when they were doing the ritual on the black man and what is her name? Fucking Madame Lalari. She fucking always wanted a Minotaur. They were doing a ritual in that show, and they were showing you what they would do to their slaves and when they would practice their magic on the golden people. Same thing they showed in fucking Jupiter Ascending. They always showed fucking golden people, same as Sparta in 300. They showed the motherfucking people covered in gold, the Persians or whatever, fucking covered gold, and these motherfuckers had on bull heads and shit and all sorts of weird torture devices. Because that's just their DNA. They've been stuck in that chakra so long. The constellation is hell. That's the stories and mythos is of hell from this place. They are a warrior class species. They're all males. This is where Saturnalia and all this shit comes from. It comes from these guys. And it's funny because in jail or in the prison system, you'll see these people, a lot of their descendants. The white supremacist races, they'll have the 8 on them, or the 88 representing the 88 constellations, or representing the 8. They don't know this, though. They don't know this, representing the 8, which is the 8th star in Aldebaran, which is the 8th brightest star. You'll see them having the 8, and you'll see them have the inverted central axis sun, which is the swastika. From Ethiopia, the reason why they have it inverted is because what they do, they take shit and they invert it because they're fourth dimensional, so their consciousness is inverted, it's lower. So they took all these different symbols, and that's where they represent the 8. You know what I'm saying? This is why you always see them with, you know, further folk and runics and stuff like that, because that's all Viking shit. That's all them. And it has to do with Enlil's tribe and Shamash and them and stuff like that, and intermingling with the Pleiadians. This is also depicted in ancient Sumerian as Epic of Gilgamesh, when you see Gilgamesh standing there, and then you see Enkidu standing there with the thing like this in the spear, the invisible spear that they're talking about. And you see them standing right there and see me with the bull horns and stuff like that. That's because I incarnated into the species at one point in time. Okay. So what else can I give y'all? Whew, it's a lot of information. So the archaeological excavations of the palace reveal fabulous murals of bull leaping games and horned emblems. In Egypt, Taurus spread it represented Apis, the bull of Memphis, who was a servant to Osiris. Now you see why they don't like you no more, because you were their servant. I mean, they were your servant to Osiris. Osiris is what Orion is, Sirius, the parent constellation of all the universes. Is Osiris Sirius? In some of Andromeda too, but Osiris is Sirius. Sirius is the mother of all of them. Orion is the father. Sirius would be considered also Aset or Isis as well. But then you have the different constellations in between that make those lower deities or those lower attributes of the stars. Reading y'all things. Yeah. Body snatchers, that's what they call them. Or body hoppers. And I ain't even getting to thought transference or how they can, how you can, they can hop body to body and shit. That's a whole nother science to it, is body hoppers. So yeah, that's why in this position and in this place, they show the Thor Ragnarok and stuff like that. But they always showed the golden people in the real Anunnaki would knock them, right? Because the higher dragons or whatever can shapeshift, and they would often shapeshift into golden melanated beings. This is true, because they'd be up there with the central suns and stuff like that, and they actually would live inside the sun. I was actually meditating the day, and the sun, I heard the spirits of the sun say, "Turn around and look at me. We are your ancestors." And I did. I always face the sun because you are my ancestor. So this is why a lot of beings became Ra's, became sun beings or ray beings. So let's see. So it is equated to the during the Ptolemy period, when all the Grecian stuff was taken over into Egypt, and they took all our bullshit, I mean, all our shit. The stars Tartarus was with what? Venus, Saturn, Mercury, Mars. That makes up the whole entire matrix. That's vampire energy. That's the energy of discipline, you know, and that's draconian energy. That's that fucking weird little insectoid things that live on Mercury and shit. Mars, that's the fucking war energy. That's all that energies. So that's pretty much what I'm going to cover with that particular one. If you saw the book, you saw the book. If you didn't, hey, you will forget. All right. So the Nordic species, the ancient origins of the Nordic gods, i.e. Nordic or Aryan. All right, the way you get Aryan, you get those from the, you get, you know, y'all see the Anunnaki carrying the little DNA harvesting bags? Those are DNA harvesting bags, all right? What they do is they go and see DNA and harvest it or whatever in the different constellations. Those are androids that y'all seen doing that. It says in the ancient Sumerian, very clearly, I can still look this up, androids were on the earth. The Anunnaki sent them. We sent them, okay? So you get out. The DNA from some type of being or some type of goat being or something like that from the Aries constellation. All right. And you mix it with a Wyan. A Wyan is a Lyan. All right. You get Ly from Lyra and you get An from Aldebaran, like Lyran. All right. Meaning that their Ra is coming from the Aldebaran sun. All right. Okay, so their blood types are AB, okay? Originally, A type. They're eighth ether and four ether, okay? So you have eight ether and four ether. When they are alive, they are eight density and eight ether. When they disincarnate, they deteriorate and become four ether and four ether, going in and out of the fourth and eighth dimensional planes in doorways. Because everything has a parallel. Dimensions go this way. Densities go this way. And parallels go in between. It's parallel. All right. So chakra set. They have one chakra. Primitive. It is the root chakra. This is why it says they were giants on the earth and they started raping women. That's these motherfuckers. Because they had to run out of Aldebaran during the war. And then they had a truce. And then that's when we had to take them into Orion. And that's when shit got real. And then they became the Watchers and the Gregorians and shit after they mutated during the Orion Wars. During the Orion War, they got disintegrated and turned into transhumans. So this is why you see their depictions of them. Thanks for the three people hanging in there listening to this, because this is some rare shit for me to just come out and just tell y'all. They had, this is why you see them standing there, and they've got android legs and cybernetic, you know, attachments to them, is because they were, half of them were blown up and they were resurrected through the Titan program, which is transhumanism. And one of them was Shamash, which was Enlil's son, who had also had mutated and lost his pigment during the nuclear wars. So he mutated and lost his pigment during the nuclear wars. And that's, this is the origin of the creation of the Pleiadian species. Because all of them came from Orion, but they mutated
and some of them were forced mutations that happened due to my fucked up experiments.
So they're unevolved, barbaric, they're horned, their DNA sequence is grafted to only four strands. It was the four strands when it was Bullman, and now they became three strands because they tried to formulate a Superman, a Supreme Man. All right. Overtly brutal in a root race. Root chakras come from root race species with only one, two, three, or four chakras. All right. The Celtic knots that you guys see, all right, or the Trinity, is representative of the first three strand helixes of DNA, the Axis Mundi. All right. They show this in Asgard and shit, the Axis Mundi. This is the represents the first three strands that they took and mutated and grafted and turned into the modern day with the Bigfoot. So you have the Shetty or the Missing Link. Why the fuck ain't no Missing Link? That's because they harvested that motherfucker. Just like why are there no more Mayans? Because all the Mayans got harvested. They disappeared. If y'all wondering what's going to happen, they're going to come harvest your ass. Y'all are seeds. You guys are food. And it's real. So y'all need to be aware of this. So when I talk about human cloning and I talk about all these different things, I'm talking about you guys are food. You guys are food. You guys are a source, a resource, like a battery. Seriously. They feed off your energy. What do you think your zodiac sign is? Your zodiac sign is a zodiac, as we say in the higher realm. Zodiac, all right? Zoo, meaning zoo, 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 abzu, right? Doc, meaning a doc or a D-O-Q, doc, okay? This is where you guys get doc or duke and shit like that. That's doc, all right? It's a what? A aqueduct. A stellar aqueduct of energy to where you harness the energy from the humans into the celestial realms. This is why they had to create more constellations around the earth, such as Aquila and, well, Aquila was always with me, such as Cassiopeia and all these other new ones that we have that nobody really knows about. So the three Celtic knots in the Trinity represent the first three strands of Nordic DNA, the tree, the axis mundi, all right? Or the DNA axis, the cosmic axis, the world pillar, the world tree is the microcosmic axis point to Asgard or Auriga. For them, it accesses them to Auriga. So when they activate these three strands, this is why you see the Nordics in jail or whatever, and they have the three strands in the hammer, all right? The hammer is called Shiruri. Or Shakuri, or something like that, in ancient Sumerian, and that's the hammer. That's supposed to be the hammer that's in the hammer bracelet. No, I'm trying to remember which one is the hammer. Yeah, I might have to forgive me on that one. That one, I'm actually be, you know, not try to be too high up and actually Google it, which is the hammer, you know. I forgot which one it is. I know it starts with a A or something like that. Constellation. Y'all gotta forgive me. I'm running a lot of information in my database in my mind at once. So sometimes I'm gonna have to look some stuff up. But I want to write a job proof as well, because a lot of people just think I'm just coming out of this shit just out of my ass. And I'm not coming out of this, none of this out of my ass. I'm coming at it from experience. Constellation. It's the hammer. It's Aquila. I just said that. See, I'm accurate even when I didn't want to be accurate. So when they talk about Aquila is also Latin for what? All right. The eagle's helmet that you see the Anunnaki wearing when they're wearing the eagle's helmet. That's also the hammer, which is Mohinor in the Thor myth. Okay. So they have Aquila. And then when you see Aquila, right, in the Thor theology, that's the raven on his arm or whatever, symbolizing death.
That's another bird. You'll see him with two different birds or whatever. But that's all taking from the Inky story, where you see me with a bird on my hand and stuff. Like, as they come and they alter shit. They're Archon. So, and that's also has to do with what Hercules, heroes, Heru, which is also what? Also associated with Aquila. You follow, okay? Make sure. And then also you got Sagittarius in there. The eagle. Yep. Located along the Milky Way, where allegedly that Tiamat's tail was. So let's see. And I'm gonna post some pictures of this stuff later when I get offline. And those of you who had the pleasure of watching this and absorbing all of this, you will understand from here on out the some of the stuff that I'd be posted, because a lot of the stuff is encoded, and I encode it purposely. The Hammer constellation. And it's also near C2's the sea monster, see, which is also Namu, which is also the last remnant of Tiamat, mother of Sirius and stuff. There go Auriga. I wish I could show y'all some pictures of these things, but I posted a lot of the stuff before. I'm just breaking it down. So. Yeah, so that's Aquila is the hammer. At one point, it was called Aquila. So that's also where the judges are. Their judges, all right, for their councils and shit. All right, so the Celtic knot, the cosmic tree, each point to Auriga or Asgard. Each knot is in the Nordic. Trinity is also equal to the DNA or etheric level of access. Okay? Three strands, only three chakras that is gained to be to by breeding and raising humans. Okay? This is how they gain the other three chakras and other shit, by raping and mating, forcing themselves on them. And this is how they became Nephilim. Okay? In my language, in Sirius, Nephilim. Naflim means, that means dirty. Naflim. That means like you're dirty. You're not like you're satanic, which is like fucked up, like not good satanic, like the other dark side. You know what I'm saying? Y'all on that other energy. We don't do that. And this is why y'all have the twist in the stories, because Zachariah Stinchin is recording their history. He's not recording our history. Our history was passed down through oral language and through handshakes. And when you guys see the Anunnaki doing the handshake, that's the passing down of history between the tribes. So everything was silent. So let's see. The first two strands are the base strands, which are reptilian or feline. But for them, theirs is more like Sheti. They grafted it over and over again, because in order to create a human, you have to keep grafting it and grafting it and grafting it and keep cloning it and cloning it until it gets perfect. So they gained these by rape and stuff like that. They also, it forms the bull man, the goat man, or the goat fish, which is UN, and the Ari, which is like the other one. These all get transfigurized into your Baphomet. Okay? So people are all out praising the Baphomet and all this. That ain't got nothing to do with none of y'all. That's got something to do with them, what they do. So upon raping the indigenous species on Earth from the formed from the black soil of one of the first Earth races, with one chakra, two strands, females called the Eva,
Okay, these are pre-ancient descendant in the Lucy found. Okay, before Lucy there was Eva. Okay, and they kidnapped the Evas and turned them into Eva boards when they made them their wives. So they would take them up on their ships and they would do experiments on them and turn them into cyborgs because they were half Borg themselves. And like I said, Ashtar Command is really Shamash, which is in Lil Sun. So when I see Ashtar Command's hand up, that's a blasting beam that you're seeing on his hand. Because he's part fucking cyborg. I met his vessel, so his vessel told me this. His avatar told me this when we met. So, he's part cyborg. And I show him, he's the one that came back with them and it took over a lot of shit under the guise of the Mardukes. So, let's see. The mother Earth chakra and the Earth Star chakra. The Earth Star chakra is 12 to 18 inches below the soles of your feet. Often called the Earth Star chakra, aligns with Earth's magnetic core in the mother Tiamat, which is our magnetic core, or Ki, or Qui, or an exotion, pre-exotion. All right, because everything is pronounced with a click, and you can still find this until in ancient Sumeria today, where they have X's in it. That's the X is pronounced with a. Because who brought the language from South Africa? If humans were created in South Africa and we had the 12 tribes of Earth, that means somebody had to bring the language from the oldest people of Africa all the way down there, and it could be transfigurized into actual language because it was all reptilians in the absolute. So this is why you have a lot of clicking, because it's echolocation and they're using their frequencies. I still do this to this day. It can be pitch black and dark and I'll start. And I can hear if there's an entity, I can hear how far, I can echo, different stuff like that. Because y'all got to understand, reptilians don't have the best eyesight. So before in ancient times, our universe was called what? Gaul. Okay, so let me break it down a little further, because within all those different monsters she's had, those were universes, those were multiverses. These were realms, embodied creatures. You feel me? Celestial. Nine minds. We have a birthday right now, 112. So one of them is Gaul, where you get the angels from, right? Meaning big. The matter verse versus the Dahl, okay, is the antimatter verse, where these things were cast into. All right, these things were in the antimatter verse. They were trapped there. So the Celtic knots in the DNA, okay, these beings come from the boar. All right, the ice giants or the Yeti or the snow Yeti from Orion, who ended up migrating to Europa and Jupiter and all that shit, right? So the Orion Yeti is their primordial race or original parent race, okay? They stole the secrets of DNA from me, okay? One being... DNA polymerization. This is where it's going to get real, okay? We're going to talk about some real shit. DNA polymerization. Y'all wonder what DNA polymerization is. Is when DNA procreates. I can't really pronounce it. Forgive me. I'm coming down off that blunt I smoked before I did this. Are enzymes that synthesize DNA, okay? So when you synthesize DNA, what do? We're going to get into that. So now what is DNA? Deoxyribonucleic nucleotides is DNA, right? So let's break that down. What happened with Adam? Adam was given what? Eva was given what? A rib. Okay. Deoxy rib, right? Because what? Tiamat was killed woman when man was created, okay? After the first genetic experiments, and this is at the point after the delayed deluge, and man had to be recreated and stuff, and all sorts of things all over again. So you have Diana, where Dio, or D, equals Diana.
Dio is Diana and Orion plus Arcturus. Arcturus is what? The arc, the bridge. Okay? During the flood, what happened? He needed to build what? An arc or a bridge. Meaning that Enki had to build an arc or a bridge, which he had to build an arc or a bridge within your DNA, which I had to do. Forgive me if I talk both ways, because I like to dissociate sometimes. Because I can't fully be myself and fully be that at the same time. I have to find a middle ground, if you guys wonder. Okay? So Oxy, the ox is Boontz, okay? In Capricornus, and Alpha Boontz, okay? The rib is Pisces. Okay, the new, okay, is Capricornus, and that's also Nun in Kemetic culture. Okay, the Leotides, that has to do with Leonides. Leonides is a constellation within Chertan. Chertan and Leonide create the Demiurge, the rift with in reality, in space and time that went rogue. Okay, that's the Demiurge. They form the dragon worm, and y'all see this in ancient Sumerian. You'll see a dragon with a lion's head. That's the Demiurge, and they took all this shit and just chopped it up and gave it to y'all spoon feds. But I'm giving it to you raw right now. The Leotides, all right. That's the water. Okay, so you have Leonite. The tides are the water, which are Aquarius, and Aquarius is what? The cupbearer. So when y'all see me posting pictures of me standing with the bird and stuff in the water flowing out, that's very symbolic of what I'm talking about. DNA, the womb, all types of different stuff. So deoxyribonucleotides is the monomer or single unit of DNA. Each comprises of partly or nitrogenous base oxyribose sugar in one phosphate group, okay? These beings stole the key to immortality via DNA replication and consciousness transfers from the technology that they stole from their rivals, the Arcturians and others. They are called Elohim, or hybrids. Okay, now you guys have the difference between Anun, Anunnaki, Anunnaki, Wanakum, and all these other different ones. Okay, these are Elohim. They have the J in it. This is why you got Mohinir. For the hammer, okay, because it is I-L-L-O-J-I-M, not Elohim or Elohim. These are different classes. So when people come on and talk about Elohim, Elohim, or Elohim, or Elohim, okay, and you also have the other ones, which are the gaseous beings, the Elohim. Those are the high jinns, where they're fucking big-ass jinn creatures, and that's what you saw in fucking Thor Ragnarok. That was an Elohim when he was shifted and he became bigger and more flamed, all right? A lower jinn is a two-dimensional or a fourth-dimensional being that has lost. He's burnt out, so he's just a shell of his former self, and he's just smoke. Often have to be contained in what? A bottle. So thank you for the two who are watching, because I've been going on for a while. Like, this is a lot of information, and this is not new. I've kicked this information before. I'm just giving y'all more in depth. I'm not holding back as much because this, we don't have time. Okay? These are hybrids. The ribonucleotide rudicose is also an enzyme responsible for the reduction of ribonucleotides to deoxyribonucleotides, which are building blocks for the DNA replication and repair, which plays a vital part of generation of cyclione adenine and in genuine deoxyribonucleotide triplophate 20 E20. I'm not even gonna give you all numbers. I ain't even gonna have to worry about that one. DNA is composed of a proteinose shoot. Pentanose sugars and one of the four nitrogenases, oxidane, thymines, exposition, and what is it? Phosphate, glucose, exposition, and phosphate, whatever. I can hear all the haters right now. Oh, he's a philosopher now.
But deoxyribonucleotides and disorders that are presented within their DNA because of DNA, weak DNA integrities, okay? Because they clone themselves and replicate themselves too much. This is why you start to see extraterrestrials all as one form. They all look the same. It's because they clone themselves out to the point where they have no individuality and they become a hive. And they have to assimilate to a motherboard, which is a cube. So they're all just transhuman or, you know, empty shells just doing their whole little thing. So deoxyribonucleotides and DNA integrity. The mDNA is dependent upon numerous nuclear encoded factors and constant supply of DNTE for its maintenance and replication of the functions of proteins involved in the nucleotide metabolism. It is purported in the heterogeneous group of the disorders associated with the depletion and multiple deletions associated with the mutations of the mitochondrial genome. Notice they deleted parts of what? The mitochondrial. They tried to make themselves more masculine. And by doing so, they lost their genitalia. So when they did that, they'd lost their genitalia. And this is the whole story of Alalu the dragon and his two sons, the two dogs, right, biting off Anu's penis. And he wasn't able to reproduce kids. Therefore, there is no fucking possible way Enki and Lil are his children. They're not. We're not his children, no. It just so happens when they take over the brotherhood, then just like a priesthood, they'd be like, hey, father. You know what I'm saying? Father. Because that's a priesthood, an order, as they would call it. Purported in a heterogeneous group of disorders associated with the depletion of deletions associated with mutations of the mitochondrial DNA genome disturbed, the homostasis of the mitochondrial DNTP pools are literally like the underlying cause and understating of the biochemical and molecular basis of these disorders. And they are all male society. And they only make, and then the Pleiades was all ended up being an all women society after they killed all the golden people and shit that were in that area or whatever. They took over that and turned it into the bull constellation. They particularly were all men, and those were all women, and they would choose when to mate and stuff with each other. And that's how you got Pleroma and all this other shit in Tartarus and that whole European thing based around Europa. So what is what unzips the DNA? Okay, so what do you do is you get the helicase enzymes and you work to unzip the two strands of DNA. The helicases are often used to separate the strand separates the strands of DNA. The double helix itself is antennial, and the RNA molecule uses energy from an ATP hypothesis or I don't even care. By breaking hydrogen bonds between nucleotides. So y'all gotta forgive me, I'm going on for a while. We're almost done though. So yeah, I think not everybody can hang with this kind of knowledge. People will be asking for it, but like, I'ma flood it. Like, my cup runneth over very well. Homeotypic and heterotypic social pathologists and continuity. They suffer from a comorbid ability, necrophilia, and they love necromancy. Mountains, Caucasians, the dead mountains. The mountains of the what? The dead. Okay? They suffer from the comorbid mobility, necrophilia, and necromania. The Celtic knots are the hyperbridging, a single chain in the link repeatedly wrapping around itself, creating a very dense structure, meaning they're not light at all. They base their structures off of protein helios, okay, which is helios is what? Heliopolis is representation of what in Kemetics? Anu. And what did they show you in when they took over Kemet and stuff like that? They showed you what? The obelisk, which is symbolic of what? The dragon's penis. And what is the head of the Illuminati? They call him Pindar, which is the dragon's penis. The obelisk. And that's why you think they have an obelisk in Washington Square or wherever it is.
They have obelisks. Those are representation of the dragon losing his penis. Okay.
The element is helium. Okay. So when you get that's a representation of the helium that is used when that is pronounced. Okay.
I think this is this is DNA gene sequence chromosome 2. It's IKZF. 2 is a via enzyme zinc fiber protein and protein binding agent. All right. Their hair is often white, blonde, red, or red, and fairly sometimes they're black. That's if they're interbreed with Talcedians, who are tall, slenderman looking creatures with black hair. Red hair comes from the Airy, or the Aries from Orion. Together, they are the Airy Tan, okay? Where they get the Titan, the Airy Tan. And after rebelling against the Orion Sirius empires, they became the Airy Yan, taking the Yan because they took over the middle star, Ilion, or Alien. Because you get Elyon, right? Elyon is the lion. All right, in Orion, okay, Elyon, okay, that's the Orion, that's the Sphinx, that's who, all right, that all has to do with the even older one, which is Chertan, where the original An came from, which are the red dragons. So you have different classes of Ans in different class, and they all kind of go under the same name with different tweaks to it, but it takes somebody to come and actually break this down. They are from Tau, or Taurus, the bull Taurus, and watch the movie Tau, y'all. And when y'all watch the movie Tau on Netflix, it shows you that they were feeding human emotions to a robot named Tau. And they were killing people and shit and putting them into the robot. And he was feeding off of their information, off their memories. So y'all think about that when y'all on these phones and stuff. Okay, and their home systems they inhabit is the bull's eye. Alde, Baran, or Baron. And where y'all think y'all get this Barons from? Who do y'all think Baron is? Baron Sandi. It's Inky. So, I think that's about it. Yeah, that's about it, guys. So, I'm done for the night. And that was my teaching. And I'm going to go ahead and check y'all comments real quick. Exactly, Tales from the Crypt. Yep, they have the missing tales, all types of that shit. Y'all can look all that shit up. Facts. Facts. Damn. Ashe. Sheldon, did you miss everything, Shell? I hope you didn't. I like how you got the own at the end of your name. Wa'aka'ume. So yeah, that was it right there, man. Coming right back at you. We're gonna go ahead and go in with the
Sabalia. It's patience.
Patience.
Folks told me, give that. Discovering the world before this world, a world buried in time. Uncovered with rhymes. Yes. No realer. We born not knowing. Are we born knowing all? We growing wiser. Are we just growing tall? Can you read thoughts? Can you read palms? Can you predict the future? Can you see storms coming? The earth was flat. If you went too far, you would fall off. Now the earth is round. If the shape changed again, everybody would have stopped. The average man can't prove up.
those are the things that he chooses to speak of. And still will research and find out the root of the truth that you seek of. Scholars teach in universities and claim that they're smart and their nose start running. And the rich get stitched up and we get cut. Wanna heal them broken bones in the bush with the wet mud. Can you re-signs? Can you re-styles? Can you make peace? Can you fight war? Can you milk cows, even though you drive cars? Can you survive against all odds now?
It's crazy.
I'm like, this will play.
When you feed people the truth, you don't know how they're gonna react. You're scared of wrongdoers, people that's just ignorant. You're scared of the truth. Be patient.
Thank you.
For now, who wrote the Bible? Who wrote the Quran? And was it a lightning storm that gave birth to the earth and then dinosaurs were born? Who made up words? Who made up numbers? And what kind of spell is mankind under? Everything on the planet we preserve in canon. Microwave it, try it, no matter what, we'll survive it. What's huge? What's man? What's human? Anything along the land we're consuming. Eating, deleting, ruining. Trying to get paper. Gotta have land, gotta have apis. So I can sit back like Jack Nicholson, watch niggas play the game like the Lakers. In a world full of 52 fakers, gypsies, seances, mystical prayers. You superstitious, throw salt over your shoulders, make a wish for the day, cuz like somebody got a doll in me, sticking needles in my artery, but I can't feel it. Sometimes it's like part of me, but I got a real big spirit, a fearless, a fearless. Don't you try to grab hold of my soul. It's like a military soldier since 7 years old. I held real dead bodies in my arms, but their body turned cold. Oh, why are we born in the first place if this is how we gotta go? Dang. All the wisdom and knowledge seekers of the world.
Somebody. Patience. Somebody. Almost time.
Patience.
Almost time. Yeah. By the power of 3x3, council is now adjourned. Walk softly and carry big sticks along your path, humans. Peace. Rakasha Emesa Rakata Umu. All right, I just want to thank everybody who watched today. Thank you for giving me a chance to speak. Thank you, all of you guys. Hit me up for whatever spiritual services you need as my vessel or my avatar. If you need to speak with Lord, I'm still here. I ain't never left. But thank you, guys.
Did you know the pen is stronger than the knife? And they can't kill it once, but they can't kill it twice. Did you know the destruction of the flesh is not the ending to life?